has said the Trump administration would deploy the necessary resources and attention without declaring a national emergency. A formal declaration of a public health emergency would give the administration additional powers to waive health regulations, pay for treatment programs, and make overdose reversing drugs more widely available. The U.S. has seen a significant uptick in deaths from opioids, with the rate of death from heroin and prescription painkillers quadrupling since 1999. Opioids are substances that can affect the nervous system to relieve pain. Prolonged use and abuse can cause physical dependence and withdrawal symptoms. Kenyan opposition leaders have demanded the declaration of final presidential election results, saying their candidate, Raila Odinga, emerged the victor in Tuesday's elections against incumbent President Uhuru Kenyatta. An opposition official said information from confidential sources showed Odinga had secured victory. A preliminary results released so far showed President Uhuru Kenyatta had won 54% of votes ahead of Odinga on 44%. The Election Commission said it hoped to have all results centralized by midday on Friday and would announce a winner soon after that. Tanzanian authorities have announced the repossession of 10 privatized companies after they have been dormant for 20 years. The country's Minister for Industry invited interested investors to apply for fresh acquisition of the companies, adding that the government will reclaim other undeveloped businesses later this month. He also warned the owners of 5 other companies and gave them a grace period to August 22nd to correct weaknesses or return the factories to the government. The move comes nearly 5 days after President John Magufuli ordered the minister to reclaim them. The government said it has started looking for investors from countries like China, Vietnam, and India to develop industries which it has repossessed from investors who abandoned them after privatization. For CRN News, I'm Wen Jing.
Check out Language Cafe, where we take you through the ins and outs of the English language, showing you how to use those words and expressions that are just out of your reach. Native English speaker Lincoln and his lively student co-host Bam Ling take a look at a new idiom in every episode and tell you exactly how to use it. Tune in to Language Cafe to make those functioning words your own.
Welcome to Language Cafe, where learning is fun and fun is learning. I'm Lincoln.
I'm Manling.
Now, Manling, today's phrase, very lovely little phrase, one that I actually don't find used too often because we don't tend to believe in them as much as we used to. But what we're talking about is an old wives' tale.